Hi guys, and welcome back to another interesting topic. Today we're going to have a look at transformers and what transformers do. Transformers are basically devices that transforms AC energy from my primary side to my secondary side. It will either step up that voltage or step down that specific voltage. Here you can see, if you have noticed, that we're actually working with a step down transformer at the moment, as my turns on my secondary is less than the turns of my primary side. Right, so now let's have a look at what we have here. Let's say for instance we have 200 turns on my primary and we have 20 turns on my secondary, and let's also say that I have 500 volts on my primary, which means I'm gonna have 50 volts on my secondary side. And the reason for that is because my voltage of my transformer is directly proportional to the turns of my transformer. Now let's just have a look at the word directly proportional. What does directly proportional means? It simply means that if we have two quantities and the one quantity goes up by a certain percentage, the other one will go up as well, which means in this case we can see that we have 200 turns on my primary and we have 20 turns on my secondary, which means the one quantity went down with a factor of 10 if you look at the primary turns and the secondary turns, which means my voltage, because they are directly proportional to each other, my voltage on my secondary is also going to go down with a factor of 10. Now if we have a look at the current of my transformer, if you look at I1, I1 is 5 amps and I2 is 50 amps, which means my current is inversely proportional to the voltage and the turns of my transformer, which means with whatever these two quantities comes down, my transformer will go up. The current of my transformer will go up. So that is why when I have 5 amps on my primary side, on my secondary side, I'm going to have 50, which means it goes up with a factor of 10. And that's why my transformer's current is inversely proportional to my turns and my voltage of my transformer. And that is why you will see why my transformer ratio formulas will look like this. My turns on my primary over the turns of my secondary is equals to the voltage of my primary over the voltage of my secondary, because they are directly proportional to each other, and they are equal to the current of my secondary over the current of my primary, because current is inversely proportional to my voltage and my turns of my transformer. Let's go to an example and see how we use these ratios to be able to solve a transformer calculation. In the example, they say a transformer with 200 turns on the primary windings and 20 turns on the secondary windings draws a current of 0.1 amps from a 240 volt supply. Now, the first thing that you need to do, guys, is first draw the symbol of a transformer. This will help you to do the actual calculation. The next thing that you will do is plot down all of the values that they've given you in the sense of where it should be. So I have 200 turns on my primary, I have 200 volts on my primary, and I have a current of 0.1 amps on my primary. The only thing that I have on my secondary side is turns of 20. I don't have a voltage and I don't have a current on my secondary side. The first question says calculate the current in the secondary winding. Next thing that you need to do is you need to decide which ratios you will use together. Here I can see I have my primary turns as well as for my secondary turns. So I am going to use my turns ratio. What I need to calculate is the current. Here I have my primary current. I need my secondary current, so I'm going to use the turns ratio with the current ratio. Right. Next thing that you do is you will plot in the values. Here I'm going to have 200 over 20. Which is equals to I2 over 0.1, which is the current on my primary side. Next thing I need to do is I need to make I2 the subject of my formula and then cross-multiply the known values. 200 times 0.1 divided by 20 is going to give me 1 amp. Next, we will calculate the voltage on my secondary side. Before you calculate the voltage, however, first write in what is the value that you obtained in your first question. There you have seen I've typed in 1 amp, and that is the value of my second current. Right, here you can see I've used the ratio, the turns ratio with the voltage ratio to be able to calculate the voltage, as well as the current and the voltage ratio, and I get the same voltage. Right, so let's go ahead and do this calculation. I'm going to use my turns and voltage ratio. There I have my turns, 200 turns over 20, and there I have 240 volts over my secondary voltage. I need to calculate my secondary voltage, so I must make that the subject of my formula. Calculate the known values or multiply. 240 multiplied by 20, there I have that. And I'm going to divide that into 200, which means I'm going to get 24 volt. Same thing I will do here. There's my current ratio and my voltage ratio. That is going to be 1 over 0.1 is equals to 240 over Vs, which is my secondary voltage, which I need to calculate. So I make that the subject of my formula. Cross multiply the known values, 240 multiplied by 0.1 divided by 1, which is the current of my primary side, and I'm going to get 24 volts. Next, we're going to calculate what is the turns ratio of the transformer. But before you do the calculation, first write in the value that you obtained in the previous question, which was 24 volt. Right, now you can see you have all the values there on the primary side as well as for the secondary side. Right, now you can actually choose which ratio between the voltage ratio and the turns ratio you're going to use to be able to calculate the turns. And the reason why is because they are equals to each other and they are directly proportional. Right, so if you take the turns ratio, you're going to say 200 over 20. And then you say, what I always tell my students is take the smaller value and say 20 goes into itself once. Write it on the side which is applicable to, because that is my secondary side and my secondary side will sit on that side. And that is 20 goes in itself once, and 20 goes into 200 10 times, and I have my ratio of 10 to 1. Right. If you want to use the voltage ratio to do that, you can say that 24 goes into itself once, and 24 goes into 240 10 times, and you can see I have the same ratio, which is 10 to 1. So thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel if you like this video, and press the notification bell so that you get notifications when I upload a new video. Thank you very much.